Exactly. And that's the one thing, it's very interesting because of all the things, and there's a lot of work in the TBI side, and there's a lot of work in wound healing in this. One of the things that a lot of the experts in the community really do believe, it's the work that you've done. That's what's going to help make photobiomodulation much more mainstream, because there's no other treatments for this.
No.
There's nothing else that you can do. And just like you said, it's a traumatic thing to lose your vision.
Oh, yeah.
So the work that you've done has been phenomenal so far. We can't wait to see what's going to keep coming in the future, and just some of the collaborations and things. Is there anything that you would like to see for light-based medicine in the next, let's say, 10, 15 years? Is there anything? How do you see it?
There's a lot of things I'd like to see. I would basically like to see, I would like to see every nursing home, every wound care clinic, every VA have a light therapy unit, or be, you know, lending units out, selling units, whatever. I would like to see every ophthalmologist. I would say, who do you see more often? You probably see an optometrist more often. You go in, they measure things in terms of your vision. If you were to actually just stick your eyes in something that would actually treat it, or someone could say, you know, you've got the beginning signs of some degenerative disease, take this home and treat yourself. That's what I'd like to see. I'd like to see everybody have access to it.
Because now it seems like the thing that's interesting in photobiomodulation now is the fact that we're finding it works on cells even before they're starting to act.
Right.
Before they start to degenerate. And that, I mean, you saw that in a couple models. I mean, you've actually been able to reverse some of the things.
Right, yeah, we could reverse some of methanol toxicity with it, which really surprised me. Nothing else actually reversed that kind of toxicity. A lot of the work that Christina Valter's done, they've done pre-treatments.
Yes.
And then they do a shocking, usually it's an intense bright light treatment, and they can block it.
Right.
And so the idea of being able to intervene before you develop this, I mean, I think what should happen with people with spinal cord injuries is they should be treating themselves before they develop an ulcer, and they'll never develop an ulcer.
And that's a really big paradigm shift
that
we've talked about
the
last 50 years in laser. It's always been disease manifests and you are coming in basically retroactively trying to get back to that state. And I think it's a really interesting different thing where you're kind of going in and saying you could treat it before.
Right. Let's prevent the disease. What a radical idea in medicine.
Absolutely.
Let's actually stop it from happening.
Absolutely.
So I think that is great.
Janis, you're like one of the pioneers in the industry. It's amazing what you've done. Thank you for spending time
with
us today. And we can't wait to see what you have in the future.
Great. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Bye.